Yeah.
Three, two, one, go.
Hi, this is Jeff Tingey, the athletic director at Idaho State University. This is podcast number 5 for me. It's March 6th, 2017. And I have the blessing this week of being in Reno, Nevada for the Big Sky Conference Men's and Women's Basketball Championship. Really excited to be here. It's a great event. It's year 2 of our 3-year contract there. We're really excited. From my perspective, I really enjoy this location. It's nice to have every team in the conference at one arena. We're all at the same hotel. It's a great atmosphere. And you know, it's as we saw last year with women's basketball, it's anyone's game. Whoever's hot gets the chance to go as far as they can. Today, my guest is Miss Andrea Williams, who is the new Big Sky Conference Commissioner. Andrea, welcome to the show.
Jeff, thank you. It's so good to be here with you.
Yeah, I appreciate having you here. Commissioner Williams began with us in July.
Right.
Hasn't even got a full year under her belt, so we call that wet behind the ears. But you're doing fine.
Or baptism by fire.
Baptism
it's all the
by
same.
Fire, throwing into the deep end, all of those other things. So we're really excited to have you. Commissioner Williams came to us from the Big Ten Conference, and we're just grateful to have you here.
Well, I appreciate the opportunity to visit with you this afternoon. Certainly, I know you and so many others are so busy with everything that's going on with the championship, but I love the fact that you still said new. You know, being 9 months in, folks are starting to add months versus giving me that new title still, so I'm going to ride that wave for as long as I possibly can. But you know, anytime anyone has asked me the question in terms of the transition, I said it has exceeded every expectation I have had from a personal perspective or professional, and at the end of the day, it's all about the people. And so I just feel very humbled to be part of our Big Sky family, and certainly just really grateful for all the great relationships that we have within the league, and just the camaraderie and collaboration that our association does so well.
Well, good. That's great. Has anyone with that time frame said, man, you've been here like a year, or have they jumped that far?
Oh, a year and a half. How long has it been? How's it going? And I'm like, no. I started lying too. I said 6 months the other day, and I realized that I had spent a little bit more time on the job than that. But I mean, it's been great. It's flown by.
Well, good. So you came to us as associate commissioner from the Big Ten Conference. How's that transition been? Because, you know, we'll say the Big Ten's different than the Big Sky.
Sure.
How's that been for you?
You know what, it's been exceptional, and you know, I had a unique opportunity. I started with the Big Ten back in 98 for about 6 years, then left and went to the national office for a couple of years, and then returned back to the Big Ten. So I never thought that I was going to have a second term with the Big Ten Conference or go back to Chicago. It was a unique time for their conference because they were starting their own television network, and so they really did put a lot of pressure in terms of television, what conferences are doing in terms of forward thinking, and how our fans and alum all take in content and live action of our games. And so it was a really special time to be able to be a part of that, and certainly everything that the Big Ten has done over the years, whether it's been independent medical spotters for football or an eighth official for football, starting their own network, I mean, concussion research, I mean, I feel like they've been at the forefront of so many things, and I've been able to kind of have a front seat to see and learn, and I believe really having a wonderful mentor in Jim Delaney. I don't think there's anyone more brighter, smarter, more talented in the sense of collegiate athletics, and so I've had a good upbringing. But I've been very fortunate with the different individuals who I've had a chance to learn from, and those who've served as my mentor as I've come, you know, along the athletic administration path for the last 20 years.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and Jim is a great commissioner, is probably a great leader. But with all of the TV stuff, I mean, you were kind of in the driver's seat for all of that, weren't you?
Well, you know what? He actually was.
Yeah.
You know, Jim, you know, there's no one more savvy in progressive thinking than Jim, and it was very important. So at the time, I was actually at the NCAA office when they started going through their renegotiation with their television partners, and Jim just believed that the Big Ten brand was far more valuable than what they were probably being offered at the time, and he found another way and a new way to go about it, and you saw a lot of conferences follow suit. Not sure anyone has the same success level as the Big Ten Network as of today, but it's changing the way that conferences do their business with television agreements, contracts, distribution, and I think it's a healthy way to take a look at it from a collegiate athletics perspective.
Good. But to change directions a little bit, here we are at the Big Sky Conference basketball tournament. You were a college basketball athlete.
Oh my goodness, so many years ago.
And a volleyball athlete, right? Two sports?
Yes, two sports at Texas A&M, that's right.
So tell us about that. For all of the Bengal listeners who maybe haven't got this introduction yet.
Sure. And I love talking about my past experience of being a has-been, as I like to call it.
That's what we all are.
I know, exactly. Just had a great pleasure to be able to continue to play multiple sports at the college level. I think there's a sense nowadays that folks want to get specialized in sport. And, you know, when I grew up, my dad's retired Air Force, military, we moved around a lot. And so based on what sport was going on, that's what you played at the time. So whether it was soccer, softball, basketball, volleyball, when the seasons changed, your sport changed. And so for me to be able to go to A&M, a major Division I institution, and play at that level in two sports, nothing could replace that experience. And I will tell you, folks ask me all the time, was it a difficult situation to be able to have coaches in two sports and your time management? And to be honest, my management of my time was a lot better when I was playing both sports. My grades were a lot better. But you want to know what? It really did introduce me into the world of administration on the athletic side. And at the time, I called myself a snot-nosed kid. I didn't know what was going on. But everyone at A&M and what you guys do at Idaho State and all of our administrators within the Big Sky, their purpose is to provide a great experience and opportunity and access to our student athletes. So they get an opportunity to go to a school that maybe they wouldn't have otherwise, to get an education paid for and perhaps leave school debt-free, and get all these wonderful resources and tools to be able to be developed for life after sport, for life after graduation. And at the time, I didn't know it. I didn't know what an athletic director did. We had an SWA, we had a director of compliance, we had academic advisors, which I would run and hide from because you didn't want to get in trouble. All these people, every last one of them had an impact in my experience. And all the work that they did supported the success that I had. And so now, being on this side, any opportunity that I get to thank them, Lynn Hickey, who's now the athletic director at UT San Antonio, she started football. They went to their first bowl game this past year. Years after graduation, I was actually working with her, and we were sitting at a bench. We were doing practices for a regional site that was in San Antonio, and I just was like, Coach, because I can't call her Lynn. And I was like, Coach, I said, if any stress or strain that I caused you, I just want you to know I apologize. I didn't know. And she was like, oh, Andrea, you were a great kid. Who knows the heartache that I put her through. But it takes time for you to step back and truly respect and appreciate what college athletics offers. And it's so much more than just competing in a postseason basketball championship, but all those benefits and values to those kids. I just have a special recognition of that because I experienced it myself.
Oh, good. Good. Well, in the Big Sky Conference, you're full of a lot of athletic directors, senior women's administrators, presidents, leaders, all around from everywhere you look. As the commissioner of the Big Sky, you are considered the top leader of the conference. How do you see yourself as a leader, and how does that kind of fit into the style of who you are and what you are?
Well, for all of our listeners out there, Jeff is being very modest. At the end of the day, the Big Sky office and in my particular role, we answer to our institutions. And so certainly work with the athletic directors, report to our presidents, but essentially it's like having 12 different bosses. And so at the end of the day, the conference office, we are there to provide service and support for our member institutions. And so that is our goal. If we're not doing it right, we certainly want to hear about it. But it's a privilege to be able to be in that seat. And in terms of, leadership, I've had some great bosses along the way, and there are some things I took from people that I thought, wow, I really want to make sure that I take that quality and attribute with me. There's some that I said, I think I could do that a little bit differently. And so for me, it's not about managing people or an organization. It's really about developing people where they are, providing opportunity for growth, and really just exceeding, I think, what is the great foundation and success and tradition that the Big Sky already has. And so because of the great leadership that we have on campus, because of the great history of the Big Sky, me coming in just gives a little bit different perspective. You'd mentioned earlier in terms of the difference of the Big Ten. It's significant. Coming from an Autonomy 5 conference to an FCS level, the biggest difference are resources and monies, and it is significantly different. At the end of the day, you're doing more with less, and I think that that's a great motto for FCS across the board in terms of we don't have all the bodies, we don't have all the money to do the things that we want to do, but we do the best with what we have, and I think that's what makes us really special.
Oh, good. That's great. Well, appreciate that. As we look at the Big Sky Conference then and kind of close it all, we're always trying to improve. I mean, whether it's a basketball team or a track team or an athletic department or a conference in general. And now that you're closing in on that year mark and are swimming in the deep end and stepped out of that baptism by fire, what ways do you see from your experience that we can strengthen ourselves, that we can improve ourselves, that you know, you can take the experience that you have to help us make ourselves better?
Sure. You know, I was actually on a conference call with the university president from Northern Colorado, Kate Norton, and she used the terminology, we're paid to keep score. And you're absolutely right in terms of we want to be competitive. I mean, certainly within the conference, schools want to vie for that championship. They want to get an automatic qualifier into the postseason. We want to advance in the postseason. We also want to be successful academically. And so whether that's through our graduation rates, through our APR, I mean, there are ways that we rate ourselves and keep count in terms of how well we do. And so those are areas where we certainly have a lot of focus. But in terms of growth, I mean, you take a look at every year and you say, okay, this is what we were able to accomplish this year. What can we identify in terms of moving forward and in terms of enhancing and improving? And I think there are a number of things that were probably low-hanging fruit for the Big Sky when I came in, and so that was probably sometimes a benefit, sometimes a challenge. And so when you talk about television and exposure that we have, you know, we've had a great relationship with Root in the past, and how do we improve upon that? I think one of the biggest assets that we have right now that we have not been able to leverage in a very meaningful way, and I think that we can moving forward, is our Watch Big Sky. The fact that 10 years ago, the Big Sky was so forward-thinking that they started their own streaming networks. I mean, we right now have an international channel that's available for free for now for our alums, our fans, and just sports fans across the world. And so to have that enterprise at our fingertips, we have to find a way to exploit it. We have to find a way to push it out to all of our Big Sky followers. And so that's very important to us in terms of how we move forward. And then I just think the postseason experience. I mean, we're here in Reno. We're here for the basketball championships. It's our second time in a consecutive year that we're at a neutral site that all the institutions can come and participate. And we say, okay, last year was a building foundation for what we're going to do this year, or last year, excuse me, what can we do differently this year? And so hopefully you, your teams, and our fans who are coming in are picking up on things that are a little bit different and hopefully a little bit better from last year. And then we're going to take that and then in year three build on that. And that should be everything that we're looking at in terms of, you know, how we admit kids to our schools, to how do we keep them on track to graduation, to how we develop them, is every year is a learning opportunity and how we can get better. And I think there's no one better in the business than the Big Sky. And so I'm just proud to be part of the family and the fabric and want to keep us going all in the right direction.
Well, great. What a great answer. I appreciate that. You know, we appreciate you joining us today. Introducing yourself to all of our Bengal faithful and everyone from Bengal country, whether it's in Idaho or Florida or overseas. We really appreciate having you on today. We really look forward to the future and all that offers us.
All right, so thank you very much. My pleasure.
Well, in finishing this off, yes, we're at the Big Sky Conference Tournament. Really want to give a great congratulations to the women's basketball team last night. Coach Sobolewski and all the ladies played very well. We matched up against Montana. It was an interesting matchup because that was our last regular season game of the year. We actually played up at their place and got throttled a little bit. So the girls needed some paybacks, and I don't know that they got paybacks, but they got a little bit of redemption, and they get to keep playing. They play again on Wednesday at 5:30. Looking forward to that, right?
9.
Oh, we're at 9. Oh, okay.
9 Mountain.
9 Mountain, okay. Oh, you know what? Yeah, I got that mistake. Sorry. Today, the men play at 5:30. Tomorrow, the women play at 8 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Mountain. That's exactly right. Getting those mixed up. You know, there's a lot of games, and we're having a lot of fun with all of those things. This is my favorite. I mean, I love just going to games, even if it's not my team, and even if I just sit for a half and then go do something else. It's a great opportunity. So, women's basketball Wednesday, 9 p.m. Mountain Time. Men's basketball today, 6:30 Mountain Time, 5:30 Pacific. Looking forward to that. Women's basketball picked up a few accolades. We're very excited for that. Coach Sobolewski has always found a great way to develop the women on the team. Really like to congratulate senior Freya Newton, who was the Big Sky Co-Defensive Player of the Year. A great opportunity for her. And then also freshman Estefina Ors, who actually comes to us from Spain. Her English isn't that great, but man, her basketball is great. And she was the freshman of the year. So we're really excited about the prospects of our future, having people like that. And then, the list goes on and on, but we're grateful for them. And, you know, Sailor Grannon was a third-team member of the All-Conference, and so we're excited for that. Otherwise, we will move forward. Men and women's tennis is on the road. Track has regionals. Golf's on the road. Softball's on the road. A lot of things going on. Next week, we'll find another great coach or staff member or athlete to interview. Appreciate everyone sticking in. And we will go from there. So from all of us here in Reno to all of you, wherever you are in the world, thanks for joining in, and go Bengals.